You need to think about it. Dang right you do. Buying a car is just as big a decision as moving or choosing a new college to go to. You should have thought about it, but the car salesman was ready for you. Why? Because they train on it. Today we're going to help you avoid their little Jedi mind control trick when you really need to think about it. Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, also known as the Homework Guy and author of Is That the Best You Can Do? This video brought to you by the Homework Guy team, home of super high intensity training for car buyers and a very savvy group of auto experts to help you out. To the disappointment of some car dealers out there, we're on a mission to create the smartest car buyers in the country. If you appreciate the Homework Guy videos and you want to support our efforts, there are plenty of ways for you to get on board with us and help us out. If you learned something today and we succeeded in making you a smarter car shopper, well, maybe we can make you an honorary member of the Homework Guy team. How's that sound? All right, let's get started. You're out on the car lot. The salesman has pumped you full of plenty of reasons that you need to buy something today. Well, there's one really significant reason he failed to mention and will never say, however. Think of it as a statistic. The primary reason they're putting so much pressure on you the moment you showed up is that over 80% of all car shoppers will never return to a dealer they've visited. That's entirely it. Odds are you aren't coming back, and now you've finally reached that point where you just want to go home. You're not on fire about doing anything today, and you're only sort of interested at best, so you say, I need to think about it. By far, one of the most common objections heard on a car lot, and they're totally ready for you. Here's what's going to happen. And here's how you can easily sidestep their game and go home like you wanted to and you need to. The salesman is going to use three tactics to confuse you, and often they get you to stay with this. I'll list the three parts and let you hear what it sounds like from the salesman, and then, of course, we'll break down the line so you understand exactly what's happening. Number one, they agree with you. Number two, they avoid confrontation. And number three, all they want is five more minutes. Here it goes.
Of course you need to think about it. We haven't covered enough information for you to not want to think about it more. I get that. Making good decisions is important to me, and I can see it's important to you too, but what I've learned is this. I'd like to go inside and give you a 5-minute presentation on what all the final numbers will be, your trade-in, the payments, and what a great price we have on our car. And then you know what? 90% of the people decide it makes perfect sense to get the car. But in the end, it's your decision. It's completely up to you. It's just 5 minutes, and if you don't get the car, it will give you all the information you were hoping to get, so you can go home and think about it. Now that's what makes the most sense, wouldn't you agree?
That was all 3 points rolled into one big run-on speech. Let's break it down. First came the agreement.
Of course you need to think about it. We haven't covered enough information for you to not want to think about it more. I get that.
You see that? You feel like they agree with you and it feels good. Then it rolls right into the strategy of avoiding confrontation and validating what you had to say, almost like advice from a good friend.
Making good decisions is important to me, and I can see it's important to you too, but what I've learned is this.
It still seems pretty safe, right? He's not in your face. Instead, he's validating what you just said. And now here comes the request for 5 minutes.
I'd like to go inside and give you a 5-minute presentation on what all the final numbers will be. Your trade-in, the payments, and what a great price we have on our car. And then you know what? 90% of the people decide it makes perfect sense to get the car. But in the end, it's your decision. It's completely up to you. It's just 5 minutes, and if you don't get the car, it will give you all the information you were hoping to get, so you can go home and think about it. Now that's what makes the most sense, wouldn't you agree?
You know, it took them a whole minute to ask you for 5 more minutes. What are the chances that seeing the numbers takes more than 5 minutes? Think about it. If you're lucky, and I mean totally lucky, it'll take up to 30 to 60 minutes for him to get those 5-minute numbers out, and that's what you've lost time-wise at a minimum. For those of you who got suckered into this 5-minute story, you gave up 2 to 3 hours more, and you went home in a car deal that was very unlikely to be a deal you should have signed at all. Here's the thing. Nobody goes to a car lot unless they're planning to buy a car, and car salesmen say that all the time. But that's right. You were there because you had at least some interest, right? The thing is, it's the same reason nobody goes to Best Buy unless they're interested in some electronics, right? The difference is that You can visit a big box store and nobody is there cramming stuff down your throat and saying they need to sit down with you for another 5 minutes if you should dare say, just looking or I need to think about it. No, instead, those salespeople thank you for your time and you go home. You think about it. Oftentimes you wake up the next day and realize you're about to do something very stupid with your money and thank God you went home and thought about it, right? Well, that's the way things are supposed to happen. What's wrong with car dealers is that they never thought it was a good idea to actually listen to a customer. They will never honestly validate your need to think about it. Such a simple statement, right? What right do they have to try to take that away from you? None. You're considering a decision that is as big as moving or choosing a new college to go to. Would you let an apartment manager or a leasing agent or a college administrator push you around like this? Or would you take your time, do your homework, think about it, and then when the time comes that you have all those ducks in a row, only then would you be making that decision? Buy a car on your terms, not theirs. That's precisely what we're teaching here on the Homework Guy channel. I hope you learned something today that when you think you need to think about it, it's because you really do need to think about it. Trust what your gut is telling you and go home. You don't owe this persistent salesman anything. Don't let his request for 5 more minutes turn into hours more at the dealership. It not only deprives you of doing your due diligence, but who needs a stranger deciding what's best for you? Seriously? Did this guy suddenly become your financial advisor too? I hope not. Go home. It's where your butt belongs. By the way, when you go home to think about it and you get all your pricing information lined up, visit our website, thehomeworkguy.com. If you plan to finance, use our car payment calculator so you know what your out-the-door price has to be if you're going to hit your payment goal. It's there. The tools are free. I encourage you to use them. It's the goal of everyone on the Homework Guy team to not only turn each of you into the best equipped car buyers out there, but also change the car business. When you take back the control of your deal, when you walk away from a pushy salesman, you not only help yourself, but you help change the car business too, and that's really important. When you've become smart enough to walk away and go home to think about it like you always should, you can consider yourself an honorary member of the Homework Guy team. You just graduated. If you appreciated today's video, consider recommending us to others and leaving that great big thumbs up. Use hashtag the Homework Guy. It helps other people find the same information. You can also email us at info@thehomeworkguy.com. If it's a contract review you're looking for, we do those for free. Just make sure you use contract review request in the email title, and we're likely to get back to you. Hundreds of emails pour in all the time, so please be patient with us. If you love what we do and wish to leave a tip on either PayPal or Cash App, the link's appearing here on the screen now. They'll be very easy for you to find. There's also lots of other ways to support us, and we greatly appreciate everything that you do. Your efforts help us get the word out and defeat the bad guys in the car business who still haven't learned that simple fairness and honesty is the best business model. Thanks everyone for stopping by to check us out today. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter. Till next time, take care everyone.